Could you imagine flying into a cave at the moon with a camera and then reporting that back to people on Earth and saying, hey, here's what the inside of the moon looks like?
We're not sure of the temperature. We're not sure if there's going to be indications of water frost. Is there ice there? Or is it going to look just like the interior of craters that the astronauts saw when they walked up to the edge of them, right? It's that unknown.
So what we've done is we've built basically a drone, which is a smaller version of the main lander that has its own propulsion, its own navigation sensors, that can then detach and fly away. It can fly kind of a hopping arc, which is fuel optimal if it needs to achieve maximum distance from the lander. It can also fly very prescribed fixed altitude trajectories for the collection of scientific data with a common reference.
So while you're flying, you're collecting incredibly valuable observations of the surface at very high resolution. We'll be collecting images that allow you to make a topographic map that's, you know, at the scale that a rover wants or an astronaut wants.
It's really magical. And we've learned so much about the moon working with ASU that it's made us better as an engineering outfit. And they've learned so much about what engineering systems can do, like the Micronova, and where we can put the instruments they want to collect data, that partnership has really been powerful. With something like the Micronova, I get different perspectives. I can fly away, I can go into the places that no one has looked at before, and then answer the questions about where is the water, what other minerals might be at the moon that we can use for a human base, and eventually for colonization of the rest of the solar system.